Uninstall Windows, install Flavor of Linux. It's time to become a hyper-polyglot GigaChad programmer. If you're a poor scrub like me when I started, you have no idea what the words operating system, programming language, and IDE really mean. And what? Like, HTML isn't even a programming language? But yeah, sorry mate, you haven't even touched real code yet. But let's change that. There's only three real things you need to care about right now, and that is understanding your operating system, which programming language should you choose to learn, and what tools are available to use. Got an apple in the corner? macOS. Familiar with the start menu? Windows. Got an erection? Linux. This is important to know while programming, as certain features of a programming language might not actually be available in every operating system. Sometimes a language might not be available at all. Let's figure out what programming language you're going to learn first. Also, probably an important note, whichever language, framework, library, or penguin you do choose to start to learn, it's realistically not what you'll ever use when you eventually get a job. If you're interested though, as a general rule, I'd say the current state of the industry is, want to build websites? Use JavaScript. Want to build websites but find yourself stuck in 2008? Use PHP. Want to work in a big corporation? C# or Java? Want to build that next unicorn app? Swift and Java? Or just JavaScript? Unless you're a nerd with a strong background in maths, it's likely when you first start learning to program, you'll be presented with an overwhelming amount of new concepts. In my opinion, learn how to program with a language that doesn't force you to follow strict guidelines. This allows you to learn the basic concepts without worrying too much about the syntax. A few years ago, I'd suggest Python to most newbies. Nowadays, I suggest JavaScript. It's an absolute monster after generations of inbreeding, but it's more flexible and forgiving than Python and most other programming languages I've worked with personally. If you disagree, leave your location in the comments below and we'll meet up in the car park later on. Alright, so I've picked a programming language for you. I mean, you've weighed up the options and you've decided that JavaScript is the best programming language for you to pick up first. So where next? Integrated development environment. If you haven't heard of this phrase before, it might not make much sense, but it's a text editor, you know, like Notepad, Word, that kind of thing, but specifically made for editing code. Most modern IDEs include syntax highlighting, plugins, integration with third-party tools such as GitHub, and a whole bunch of other cool stuff. Most importantly though, make sure you spend the first 45 minutes of setting up your IDE to switch between all the different themes and make sure you're the coolest kid around at the coffee shop. We need to figure out what tools are available to use, and depending on what language you've chosen to learn will slightly change what my recommendation and tools are. In general, I'd say Python, PyCharm or VS Code, JavaScript, VS Code, Java, IntelliJ or Eclipse, and .NET, Visual Studio Code. If you're trying to be an absolute GigaChad and learn C, C++, or Rust as your first language, it's going to be really difficult for you to really understand the core concepts of what the language is actually doing. And depending on the language you've chosen, you'll also likely need to install the relevant libraries and programs to actually run those languages. If I think back to when I started to learn, I thought you could just run any programming language anywhere and it would just, you know, sort of run. It's a computer after all, isn't that kind of what they're supposed to be doing? But no. Unless you're writing in binary, all programming languages are really just compilers or interpreters that convert your mess of text into something a computer can understand. That print command is really just a high-level command to tell the computer to initialize some memory, place some string in it, and then display it to the screen. Most interpreted languages, in fact, just convert your code into C or C++ anyway, which then gets compiled and eventually converted into something the operating system can understand. If you're learning JavaScript, the program that actually runs the JavaScript code is built into the browser itself. I personally use Chrome because I find it has some of the best dev tools, but you're welcome to use Firefox or Microsoft Chrome. I mean Edge. They're both fine too. Instead of just giving you a list of guides to go and follow, I want to leave you with a list of concepts and tips to go and weigh to learn your chosen language. After learning these things, you'll be able to easily switch between any language anyway. Tip number one is all programs follow a very specific flow. You get given some input, you're going to process some data, and you're going to produce some sort of output. So for example, if I'm logging into a website, my input is my username and password. The server will go and check if my username and password is correct. And the output is typically to produce a token or session and redirect me to another part of the website. Number two, figure out what data types are available in the language. Say I want to create a website with a login page, how do you even store the data people are putting into it? Ideally, you want to understand how to store strings and characters, numbers, and how to represent actual nothing inside of the program. Once you understand the basic data types in your language, figure out how to store groups of data, and especially how to represent a list and some sort of key value store. A list allows you to store a group of variables together in a specific order, say like a shopping list, and key value stores allow you to create a model of data. So for example, say I want to convert between country names in the respective countries, I could look for the key for US and see that the value for it is United States. Next, you want to keep your code dry, and this means don't repeat yourself. Functions are probably the biggest thing to help you achieve this, and you need to learn how to stop yourself from rewriting the same piece of code over and over again. Functions allow you to wrap up pieces of code to make them easier to reuse afterwards. Imagine we're doing this complicated calculation over and over again. Instead of writing the same line, you could write a function to wrap up this and call that multiple times instead. This also makes it easier to change what the function is doing too, as you can just change it in one place and don't have to go and update every reference where you're adding those numbers together. Understanding package managers. So notice how big games from certain publishers can be pumped out every year with just incremental updates. And no one wants to reinvent the wheel every single time you're starting a new project. So what they're doing is they're obviously taking last year's product, adding some updates and shipping out again. And as much as we joke about this, most products are actually kind of doing the same thing out there anyway. So to get more out of the language you're using, you can lean into the language's ecosystem and take advantage of the libraries and frameworks that, you know, some other genius has already put into the effort of creating. This helps turn a lot of tasks you'll need to do with your language into an engineering task, where your real job is just screwing in the bolts in between different frameworks and libraries to achieve what you need. Some great examples of this are machine learning and server libraries. No one wants to recreate a program to decode a TCP packet every time they want to create a website. Now, for my final tip,